HTTV with Illingworth and Gregory. Kazi, thanks for joining us. How disappointed are you with the result today?
Hugely disappointed with the result. Equally, if not more, disappointed with the performance, to be honest. First half, didn't start great, weren't great with the ball. We didn't compete, which we knew we'd have to. You know, it's a physical game and you've got to be aggressive, you've got to be determined in your challenges. It was too often first half, you know, as a start point. We came out second best in a lot of those situations. And it sort of sets a tone for the game then. With the ball, we were a little bit sloppy, trying difficult things, you know, things that we wouldn't normally do. In terms of, like I say, performance-wise, disappointing. And then second half, to be fair, was worse. You know, we sort of got into them a little bit at half-time. You want the reaction, do you know what I mean? And it was poor. It was disappointing. It was, you can come up with a lot of different words for it. You know, sloppy in possession, a little bit lethargic in our movement. We actually defended reasonably well. For most of the game, you know, limited them to hardly any chances until late on, which we had to defend well because we kept giving them the ball back. And then even, you know, the nature of the goals at the end sort of summed up the performance really. Again, sloppy, people switching off, poor decision making, and ultimately, you know, gifted them two goals. So as it's going the game, you think, you know, you're hoping that you can see it out, you know, get the result, and then obviously get into the performance, you know, afterwards and really analyse and look at why we were off it like we were, individually and as a group right through the team. But like I say, the nature of the goals late on as well is tough on the players. You know, it's a big learning curve as well, and the nature of them as well is disappointing.
Why do you think the performance was like that? Is it because of the stature of the competition or because they were playing at the John Smith Stadium? Why do you think they had that lacklustre performance?
No, I think it's, you know, I think we can come up with excuses if we want to do. You know, a lot of the players have played at the stadium before. Certainly the players who play in the 23s have had a few games on here. And it's, you know, FA Youth Cup, a little bit on it. You know, on paper, obviously, maybe favourites to win the game, which is a different sort of situation to have to deal with. And, you know, unfortunately, didn't deal with it particularly well. You know, and like you say, you know, all the performances this season, certainly in the league, albeit, you know, we might have lost games, we've lost them playing in a certain way. And, you know, sort of expressing ourselves and showing in those games what we're about. Unfortunately, you know, for us, for the players and for anyone obviously here today, you know, that's as far removed from what we would expect as you can get. But this is when it really matters, in the Youth Cup at the stadium. So individually, you know, the players and us as staff, we have to look at it and you know, make sure that there's a lot of learning from it. But ultimately, can't happen again. You know, the lads have got to win the step on here, they've got to perform.
How disheartening was it for you as a member of staff and the players out on the pitch to lose the game so late on as well?
Yeah, I mean, that's always obviously it's gutting, you know, to lose. You know, it's FA Youth Cup. You want to win the game, you want to play well, you want to perform, you want to compete without a doubt. But you know, the result is important, and winning the game, seeing the game out, getting a 1-0, you know, we would have obviously taken that and moved forward with it. But you know, to concede the goals, and again, you know, the nature of the goals is extremely poor. Lots of individual errors in amongst it, and that was sort of, like you say, that was the way the game had gone for 85 minutes in terms of performance, and then it was capped off by, you know, two really poor goals at the end.
You mentioned before the game that Wimbledon were a very strong Category 3 side. Do you think they posed you different threats today than what you would normally get in the Professional Development League? The fact that they were more physical and a lot stronger?
No, I think, you know, there's teams in our league that are physical, that compete, but so do we. You know, you have to be. It's not, you know, it's not how big you are and how strong you are. Sometimes it's about how willing you are to put your body into a challenge and how determined you are to come out with the ball. Size is only a part of that. You know, I think the mentality to be aggressive and determined and go and win those challenges is more important, and that's something that we've seen from the players regularly. Unfortunately, it was something that, you know, collectively today was missing. We knew what to expect from Wimbledon, the players did. Credit to Wimbledon, they came and, you know, performed very well, did what they're good at, and they're good at it. And you know, the challenge that they posed, we didn't meet it head on, which is, like I say, disappointing. And then obviously after that, we didn't impose ourselves on the game either.
Despite the result, do you think today's match will have benefited the players' development in the long term, though?
Yeah, absolutely. You know, pain, that hurts, that you know, they're in there devastated, and they should be. And again, as the result, yeah, but, you know, performance as well, they'll look at it individually and think, you know, that was nowhere near. That was nowhere near what I'm capable of, what I've produced time and time again over the season. And, you know, they've got to work out quickly how that happened. And and make sure that the next time they're in this sort of situation that they can perform and certainly compete. And they'll definitely learn from it, without a doubt. They have to do. It's part of football sometimes. Sometimes you can't play well, but you've got to dig in, you've got to fight, and you've got to be resolute right till the 94th, 5th minute, not for 85.
Obviously, now we're going into the Christmas period where the lads will go away for a few weeks. What's the focus then? What's the main focus for them in training when they return?
Well, there's always, you know, the focus is always to improve, you know, always to work hard. You know, there's players that will be playing in the 23s, there's players competing to get into the 23s, there's lads who want to, you know, play every week for the 18s who are getting pushed from the under 16s who are a good group. So you're always competing for the shirt. It doesn't matter, you know, what age group you're playing in, you're competing for the shirt. And, you know, in terms of, you know, they've all got aspirations to have careers in the game, and certainly they've got to look at today, take a lot from it, and they've got to be a lot better.
Just finally, there are almost 250 town supporters here today supporting the academy. How good is that from a support point of view, that people are coming to get behind the 18s and the Youth Cup?
Yeah, it's fantastic. You know, the support around the club at the minute, you know, you only look at the first team, the stadium's full most weeks, the away support's fantastic. And it was great today to get that many in the stadium. Again, that adds to the sort of huge disappointment in terms of performance. You know, they'll obviously go away, and it's, you know, having a look at what they've seen today, and it's not a reflection of what we're capable of. But ultimately, this is where you're judged in these big games at the stadium, and, you know, it's disappointing, you know, like you say, that we haven't been able to put on a performance for the supporters who turned up to support us.